another video in this Making Old Civil War Dress series. I have just finished cutting the patterns necessary for this part, which is the inner sleeve, and I am making this from the same fabric as I made the chemisette, because they are going to be visible under the main dress, so that's why I want them to be of the same color. So like I said, just finished cutting the patterns in cardboard, and now I am ready to mark the fabric and cut it. So if you want to see how we make the inner sleeves, come along and enjoy. Only down to the big circle markings, and I made a double hem in the bottom here because this is where the cuffs will come. But this part, these two, I have stitched from the outside because this stitching will be visible and it will look nicer when you stitch it from the outside. So in order to bast this edge, I have a regular needle and some white thread, and I'm just stitching manually all the way around, and I'm gonna do it double, two times right next to each other, because it's such a long distance and it will be easier with two lines when you're going to gather the fabric later. So here we go. I am trying to keep the same distance from the edge all the time and about the same size on every stitch that I make. So now this is the part where you need a little bit of patience, because this takes a little bit time. So I will see you when I am finished with the basting. Okay, so now I have basted two lines. Unfortunately, I did that with a white thread. You could preferably use a different color thread, but I am an amateur, and I guess this is the proof. But anyway, there's two lines of basted thread here, which I will use for gathering the fabric later. Next step now is to take the top side and make a casing for the rubber band. So I will fold about 2.5 centimeters. That would be about 7/8 of an inch. First, and then one smaller, about 1/4 inch under there again, and that way make a casing all the way around for the rubber band to go into later. That's the next step. So I'll catch you when I have done that. Finished putting the elastics into the top of the innersleeves. So the next step now will be to add the cuffs. Here they are, with interlacing to the bottom section, and gather the fabric. Sew it on. Now I have attached pins to the cuff all the way around, and also gathered all the fabric inside. And then it's time to attach it by stitching a seam along this outer edge all the way around. And there we have it. It's now stitched to the inner sleeve. So now I have to take this cuff facing, this one, and I have to fold it over in one end and attach it to the already attached cuff, the first half. That's what I'm gonna do now. Quick and easy, and then I attach this to the first half of the cuff. there. Now I have attached the last half of the cuff to the first half, and I have left the hemmed edge open. So now I will cut the corners in both ends and trim along the stitching and turn it inside out. The corners, and I will also cut a little bit along the stitching like that, and all the way around, because it will make it easier when you turn it inside out. So I'll catch up with you again when I have finished cutting all the way around like that. Now I have cut all the way around, and it's time to turn it inside out, and it's very easy to do so. Try to squeeze the corners out to make it as square as possible, or as straight as possible. Same on the other end. Like so. And then you press along the seam till you get a nice and even cuff. And there you have the pressed cuff. So now, next step is to attach the lacing around, same as we did in the previous video when we made the chemisette. We used the same lacing for the cuffs. There you go, the lacings are attached. They are attached on the inside. As you can see there, attached on the inside, and this is from the outside. The stitching is done from the outside. Sorry, the stitching is done from the outside to make it look slightly better. But yeah, I think it looks good for first attempt. Yeah, now I just finished making the buttonhole and attaching the button on the other side. So now I will test it on the woman that will wear this. And there we have it. These are the inner sleeves. And as you can see, they don't go further than just up to the top of the elbows, because these are just filling under the normal dress. I am pretty pleased with this result, with the lacings and everything. So, now on to the rest of the dress, but that will follow in the next part. So guys, that was the end of Civil War dress part 2, the making of the inner sleeves. So now, next part will be the main dress. I will take you through more of those details in the beginning of part 3. But if you are pleased with what you have seen so far, please come back and watch part 3. And also go and check out the other part, the first part when I made the chemisette. And also the first video we ever made on this channel, the unboxing of Civil War equipment together with my captain, Dusty Fogg. So go and check them out, and please don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. And if you have comments on anything that I have done, because I am an amateur, please leave some comments so I can learn more. Thank you again for watching. See you in part 3.